could you devote even 1% of the time and energy that you have devoted to knowing the truth? Could you devote even 1% of that to knowing the false? Then surely some difference would have been created by now. You are chasing that which is beyond your chase. But you are not looking at that which is immediate all around you. When I am asking you simple questions about your life, you are saying, I never thought about it. Why are you going to those people? Why are you listening to the... Why are you following what the world is doing? You are just saying because everybody does that. Should you be talking about the truth, or should you be looking into this tendency to follow the crowd, to work without knowing, to not to observe, to not to attend? Is this not more important? But this takes up not even 1% of your concern, right?
Yes.
Because this is small. Not as large as planet Earth, because it is not endorsed by the billions of people. So you don't go into it. Go into your daily life. See why you are listening to somebody. See why must somebody be a hero to you. The very small things, the very ordinary, daily, petty things, and that is spirituality. Do not talk so much about the truth. When you are talking so much about it, you are reaffirming to yourself that it is a word. Only words can be talked about. No point taking the name of truth again and again. You are doing yourself a disservice by giving it a name. Rather go into the immediate issues of your life. Why are you sitting in a particular way? Why are your eyes are closed? Do you know? And that can be known, because all that is within the province of mind. So all that can be known. That which can be known, we refuse to know. We say, oh, it is so ordinary. Why must I invest myself in knowing it? Oh, why must I be attentive to why I am shaking my hands right now? Oh, why must I be attentive to why I am chewing my nails right now? Why must I be attentive to what I am wearing, what I am eating, where I am working, how am I earning? Why must I think about all these things? These are such small matters. I would rather think about and analyze the truth, God, the beyond. I would rather talk of that. You were driving a while back. How was the Yamuna today? Hmm? What was the rate of the carrot they were selling? On the footpath. You are getting late. And when a place is calling, when something is important, then you do not see even that which is presenting itself to be seen. So does observing or seeing require a particular skill or trick? Or is it so that lack of observation comes from something that you are holding close to yourself? Now, irrespective of how right, how appropriate, how correct, how sacred all that appears which you hold close to yourself, it will still block observation. It doesn't matter that it is profound. It doesn't matter that it carries a sacred name. It doesn't matter that your thoughts, beliefs, emotions are closely attached to it. Thoughts in the mind are the blinders upon the eye. When the mind is covered with thoughts, take that as an eye covered with blinders. Then even if your eye is open, it will not observe. And the mind will not think about anything except that which is important to you. Had it been unimportant, the mind would have dropped it long back. It would have even faded away from memory. We all surely hold a few things to be important for us. Whatever is important, whatever will ever become important, will blind you. Hmm?